I can try that. Huh. Sometimes I surprise myself with the ideas that I have. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. It's early. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. I'm getting ready to go grocery shopping, and I thought, let me try some new goodies. So that's what I'm going to do today. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I love everything about makeup. Eyeshadows are my passion though. And then especially colorful eyeshadows. Yeah, that is truly where my heart lies. Although I am finding my love for neutral eyeshadow as well. If that sounds of interest to you, if you love color as much as I do, or you want to get into color, or you are older and you want to know how to be fabulous being older, or you are having trouble finding the correct shades on your light olive complexion like me, then make sure that you are subscribed, because I upload a lot. Currently 5 videos a week. Yeah, I never know how to end that part. I can just stop by then subscribe. Or I would love it if you would subscribe. That's basically the gist of it. Yes. What I have done is I put some primer on my face, which is the Catrice One Step Skin Perfector. Oh, I feel about it though. It makes me look shiny. But yeah, it does have a certain grip to it, which is good. And I also put a tiny bit of color corrector here in the inner corner, because I need it today. Yes, I am, however, now going to do my brows. And I'm going to, or shall I try the wax? Shall I do the wax again? Because I haven't tried that one on camera. I've actually been using this one, the honey glue from Pink Honey from the UK. I really, really like it. But I also have a Wonder Wax, so let me use that one today.
Is this clean? Not really. Do I have a clean spoolie? I should, somewhere.
So they say that this can be used just as is. It is a little bit well, I don't want to say cold here in the room, but it's maybe a little bit chilly. And I think you need to warm this product up a bit. I'm just working it in my brows. I'm basically doing this with the spoolie, and then I'm actually working it a little bit on my hand, because the product is just a little bit too cold, I think. I'm just brushing my hairs down first, and then in the direction I want them, and then I'm going to kind of put some things up, you know. I did notice though that with this product I cannot keep working it. So the honey glue, for instance, when I dampen the spoolie. Can you keep everything in one piece here, please? Thank you. When I wet the spoolie a little bit, I can work with it a little bit better. And I feel that when this sets, it sets, you know? Which is a good thing. I do always remove a little bit of extra there and there. Yes. While this set, let me show you the eyeshadow palette that I'm going to use. It is from Asgard Queen Cosmetics, and it is the Nertus Temple palette. Now, Asgard Queen Cosmetics is a Russian based indie brand. She makes everything herself. She started with loose pigments, and I actually have some loose pigments from her. Quality is really, really nice. And then she went into pressed eyeshadows, very, very tiny, and then she basically graduated to bigger pans. Yes, let me swatch the palette as well, or show you the swatches of it. Now, the swatches are a bit wonky. That is because the palette did not swatch the best. The shimmer swatched fine, the mattes not so much, but it is more important to see how they behave when you are doing an eye look, right? What I did notice is that especially the mattes are very, very hard pressed in the pan. I'm also eating a sandwich. I need my breakfast. And also, she also has an eyeshadow primer. It's a colorless one, I think, at least. And here it is. I'm going to try that one today. I also have a lippy in the shade Serin, which is an orange. And I have a blush in the shade Gefion. And the embossing that you see on here is the Wegvisier, if I pronounce that correctly, which is basically a magical compass. that's it in a nutshell. So actually, people think that it is a Norse or Viking thing. It's actually Icelandic. Just so you know. Fun fact. Okay. Yeah, my brows have settled. So now I can kind of do foundation. I'm going to use the Essence Pretty Natural foundation today in the shade Warm Cashew. I don't know if it's too dark, but we'll see. Should have a lighter one somewhere. And I'm going to mix in some green concealer because I need to green this up. Which isn't weird, because honestly, I need to green almost anything up. Although this is kind of green of itself, a little bit. It's a little hint of a green, so I don't have to green it up as much. This particular foundation is very, very mask proof. It's not high coverage though. If you're wondering what I have on my bread, because it looks very bloody, right? Peanut butter on my bread, and then we called it sambal. It's this is in the Indonesian variety, I believe it is. Yeah. It's actually kind of like a chili paste. That you can eat. You can put it into a sauce or into a dish, but you can also eat it on top of something, like I'm doing now. Very tasty. Let's see if the foundation wants to play nice with the primer. Now, if you want an alternative to the Fenty Skin Tint, and this could be something for you. I do have to say that the Fenty one has better coverage, but that all depends on what you want. This is more mask proof though. When this sets, it feels like there is almost a sticky primer in it. And it is truly mask proof. It's a beautiful foundation. It's just not high coverage. You can build it up, but not indefinitely. What do they say here? I think medium. I think they say that you can build it up to medium. And when I want to build this one up, I actually grab my fingers a bit. I'm actually going to mix two concealer shades. And the concealer I'm using is the True Skin from Catrice. And I just mixed two shades on a sheet. And I'm going to tap it where I need it. Let's grab some cream products. Let's do orange. So I'm grabbing the shade Tiger Lily for blush. And my KKW stick for contour and bronzer. I'm going to do that really quickly. I am going to put on some eye primer because I don't really know how long it needs to set for. I'm just going to basically smear it on the eye. And tap over it with my fingers. It is time for blush and highlight. I'm actually going to use a loose pigment from Mandage Beauty. I used this yesterday as highlight and it's actually very pretty. So there's a sifter system, so I'm just going to do this. Open up. And then grab from here. Basically, I'm going to start where I put the highlighter and then blend it down to where I want my blush. Let's go to the blush, and I have grabbed a brush that's a little bit denser. Let's see how it will pick up. Now, she's very, very light skin tone wise. Oh, it does pick up. But I need to kind of dig in my brush a bit. And it blends beautifully over the highlighter. I'm always doing this, blending over the edges with a blender. Now, I don't know if they have shade names. I don't think so. I am going to start with this shade here. It does pick up, but it's very, very light. Now, also, this is a pretty big fluffy brush, and I am digging my brush in, or swirling my brush in. I don't have a lot of kick up in the pan, though. Now her primer I'm going to deepen it up a little bit with the same color, just a slightly smaller brush. The primer is sticky, but not very, very... No, it's not really sticky though. I don't know what kind of base it is, but if you are looking for a primer that is see-through, this could be something for you. No, let's go to my Nabla one, or at least one of the Nabla ones, still the same color. Very, very hard pressed this shade. I can get pigment off, as you can see, but it is a very hard pressed shade. It does layer, which is good. I am going to go next to the darkest blue. It layers well and it blends out well, which is very good. And this is a shade that is buildable and blendable. I'm going in with a fluffier brush because I don't want it to run away from me. Back to the first shade to blend over a little. I'm going to go to the light green, and it's going to go underneath my eye. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to grab the primer with a brush. I'm going to put that here because I have already set underneath my eye and these shadows need a base to stick on. I'm just putting a little bit of primer here. You can do this with a I usually do this with a shimmer primer for shimmers, but you can do it for mattes as well. Just use a normal primer or a glitter primer, you can. Then I'm going to go back into that green. It does show up. It's not as vibrant as I would have liked, but that's maybe not the color for it as well. The green is going to go on the bottom. That's at least the idea a little bit. I'm going to go to the darkest green first. Just with the brush that I have here, because it's okay. Tap it off. It's a very, very nice shimmer. Glides on effortlessly. Okay, I'm cleaning my brush. Then I'm going to go to the lighter green shimmer. And they are dry. I'm not spraying them or putting them on top of a sticky base, because they're going to go on top of an eyeshadow. With a slightly bigger brush, I'm going to grab that green, dark green shimmer. Okay, then I'm going to go to the other shimmer. I'm going to brush that over, kind of keeping it in the middle. I have one shimmer left that I'm going to grab now. Ooh, it picks up a lot. Oh, that's nice. Also dry. Very, very pretty. I am going to finish off the eyes, think of an eye pencil, something for the inner corner and falsies, and then I will be back and I can do a lippy and tell you what I think about the stuff that I just used. So in my inner corner I used a shade from Divina called Gumballs. It's this one, which is very, very pretty and shiny. And I just added a lip liner as well, which is from Catrice. It is a plumping liner in the shade Polite Rebellion. Yes, and now I am ready for the lippy. Let's see. It's a drier formula. It is maybe a little bit harder to put on the lips, but the pigmentation is there. It also seems to be a minty in it. I'm not sure though. It's a matte formula and it could very well be that it kind of needs to settle a little bit. That the top layer just needs to be removed a little bit. I like how it turned out. I like it. Yes, let me go over everything that I used so far. The Wonder Wax. This is actually the second time that I'm using it. I do like it. So, yeah, definitely a contender. If you like a product like this, if you like a waxy product like this, it works well with my NYX brow product that I have as well. So, yeah, I like it. And it keeps my brows in place for a very, very long time. All day, actually. Let's go next to the blush then. I think that the color is very, very pretty. I like the embossing in it. It is a formula that is buildable. If you're very fair, you will like this. If you are darker than tan, maybe there won't be enough pigmentation for you there. For me, it works. I need to build it up. But I think that the color is pretty. I think that the formula is nice. I don't know how long it will stay on for, especially with a mask. So I will keep on trying this one because, yeah, mask-wise, a lot of things will kind of rub off, you know? So, yeah. But I do really, really like the color. And I personally like a blush that's buildable. I did have to dig my brush in, or at least the brush that I used, to get pigment out because it's so hard-pressed. But I can also try it with other brushes. And I will. And I will let you know in my review roundup of the month of, what are we in now? In May, which will be online in June somewhere. I will give you my final thoughts on the blush. So let's next go to the eyeshadow primer first. I need to try this out a little bit more. It does feel like it grips the shadows well, but I want to try it with other formulas. I also want to try this eyeshadow formula with other eye primers that I normally use. I don't know, it did its job, but I need to try it out because usually the eye base that I use has a base shade in it. So I need to try this one out more. And I will get back to you on that. First impression is, I think it's nice. Okay, then the eyeshadow palette. I actually forgot to mention that the complete package is fully biodegradable. It is actually an empty palette. It's cardboard, it's an empty palette. And it's magnetic as well, right? Oh no, it's not. I thought it was magnetic, but it's not. So the pans are just glued on top. So basically, if you are done, you can take the pans off and you can recycle everything, which I really, really like. The ingredients are also on the back. Now, the ingredients that are in here, there are not a lot of ingredients in here. A few mica types, titanium dioxide, natural hematite, natural ochre, iron oxide. So a lot of natural materials that she used to color the eyeshadows, which I think is very, very nice. Let's start with the mattes. The mattes are very, very hard pressed in here, which is not really weird. I think she presses everything herself, so it could very well be that my palette is harder pressed than another palette because she does everything by hand. I could get pigmentation out though, and especially this shade, it kind of surprised me because I thought that I did not pick anything up on the brush, but I did. The brushes that I use are synthetic brushes. If you want to get more pigment instantaneously, grab a real hairbrush because it does make a difference. That is why I switched to my Nabla brush to kind of see how it did then, and it did pick up more eyeshadow. This shade was very light. When I went to put it underneath my eyes where it was set, it did not really show up for me, at least. That just means that you need to use these on a sticky base if you are my skin tone or a bit darker. Now, if you are more fair, I don't think you will have a problem with these showing up even if you set your base, but I think that especially these two shadows show up more on top of a sticky base. This shade surprised me. It's very, very nice and blendable, and it's very nice and buildable as well. And a lot of the time with darker blues like these, they can be very stiff or very lackluster or very sticky, very difficult to use. This one was very, very nice to use. You can work with them very well. You can layer them, you can blend them, but again, use them on top of a base that is not set, because then they will just show up better, which isn't weird with the color scheme that it has. The shimmers are gorgeous. Gorgeous. I used them dry. I did not need to spray them. If you do spray them, they will be more intense. But I did not need to. I did have some fallout, but not a lot. And I could wipe it away easily. So yeah, I think that is it. I think that the color scheme is very, very pretty. Green and blue. And then that, this, I don't know, what is it, orangey shade that she put in. Yeah, I think it's very, very pretty. And I love the whole aesthetic of this. So yeah, is it worth the price? Because it retails for a little over 22 euro. Is it worth the price? You have to decide that though. I think all in all, with the work that she put in here, with everything that it is looking, yeah, I think it is. But that is it for me. Yes, I got this in PR. Would I have bought it if I did not receive it in PR? I probably would have. Eventually. Not maybe right now, because I had a lot of things going on when this palette launched. And this palette is actually quite new. I talked about it in a Let's Talk Makeup video. So, yes, I would have gotten it eventually, but maybe not on launch. That is the gist of it. But yeah, she did send it to me in PR, and I'm very, very happy that I got to try her pressed formula, and I do like it. Yes, let's go. Did the blush? Did I mention blush? I did, right? Yeah, eyeshadow primer I mentioned. I forgot to tell you, actually, she also sent me the Morning Dew Elixir that I have downstairs. I tried it once, and so far I do like it. I don't know how my skin will react to it. I have no idea, but it is based on aloe vera, and it creates a certain stickiness. So I could technically, I think I could even use it as a glowy primer. I can try that. Huh. Sometimes I surprise myself with the ideas that I have. So let's go to the lippy then. The lippy, the lippy is a little bit of a drier formula, and that's probably ingredient wise. And it's also probably, I think, in summer when it is warmer here, it will be a little bit easier to apply because it tucks a little bit. But I do get a lot of pigment out. Now, if you have dark lips and you really want to build this up, I don't know, maybe you need to use a brush or warm it up a little bit first. I don't know. But I do like it. I like the formula. I like the way that it looks on me. I think it's very, very pretty. But this is also one that I will keep on using. Let's see. It does transfer, but it doesn't transfer a lot. So that is good. And it's a matte formula. Yeah, that's it. I really like it. Thank you so, so much for sending this over for me, over to me. I'm very happy that I finally got to try out your pressed formula. Everything I use on my face will be listed down below. That is it. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye guys. Fortunately, my brow hairs have grown back a little bit. Basically, what happened is I trimmed them. I should just not, because I trimmed them too short, and then they kind of stopped here a little bit, so they did not go over the bump anymore, and they just basically stood out like that. Yes.